unbelievable act. See how Bishop Oyedepo collected the money he gave to a beggar. Revealed. Bishop David Oyedepo, the general overseer of the Living Faith Church worldwide, spoke at the first service, First Tabernacle. It was the covenant day of favor service, and he spoke about understanding pathways to godliness. While talking about the earthly cost of ungodliness, the man of God revealed that ungodliness destroys destiny as he focused more on the issue of pride. Let's just pick the subjects of pride. Pride goes before destruction and a hearty heart before a fall, he said. According to the man of God, there are people that are spiritually proud and financially proud, but some people don't have to be anything to be proud. I gave someone something one time like that, and he said it was not enough. I said he should bring it. He gave it to me. I said, thank you. God resists the proud. I don't owe you a thing. I just extended a heart of love to you and you rejected it. He further explained that any sin against your body makes God destroy that body. I support the bishop. This very act that has been put up by this beggar is generally observed in all beggars. In fact, it is now becoming too much of these people. When you give them something, instead of them to appreciate, they'll complain and say it's too small. It's too small. It means that you are saying that what the person has given you is not enough. It's not enough. Oh, he should give you his life. The little that the person have, he decided to share it with you. And you're saying it's too small. Do you know the quantity of money that is with that person? Do you know the amount that is with that person? Do you know if that is the person's last card and the person decided to give it to you just because he saw you begging? Do you know? You don't know. You don't know. Instead of you to show an atom of appreciation, you are complaining. You see? He's right. I support him with that, in that action. I support his action. That is how it's supposed to be. That is what should be happening. To all beggars, they should be like that. And we do the same. If I observe anything of such, yes, aside from Bishop Oyedepo saying it, someone has experienced it as well. And the person gave me a testimony of it, and I said, you are right. I supported the person. Why not? Because the beggar actually showed a sign of pride. You don't have to apply pride when you are begging. You don't have to raise shoulders when you don't have. You don't have to feel pompous when you know that you are empty. Be down to earth. Be down to earth. Bring yourself down completely. Don't present yourself up when you know that you are not there. Cut your coat according to your size. Stop calling yourself what you're not. The humble, Jesus blesses the humble. Jesus blesses the humble. If you're not humble, forget it. Jesus will never bless you. Because he has said it, that I have come only for the unrighteous and also for the humble. If you are too proud of yourself, you will never get a support from God. I know that a lot of persons will be saying what Bishop Oyedepo has done is wrong. You are entitled to your opinion. That is why this very channel is open for us to come in and air our opinions. You understand now? So, my dear viewers in the house, I tell you that Bishop Oyedepo have not done anything wrong to deserve any embarrassment, because it is the person that actually caused it. Okay? Giving alms supposed to be giving with your whole heart. Sure, sir. giving with your whole heart, giving what you have. You cannot give what you don't have. You only give what you have. You only give what you have. And whereby you give and the person is not appreciating the alms that you have given him, so be it. Let him go somewhere where he will be given what he wants. Do you understand? Most of these beggars are like that. When you give them a little, they will be demanding for a bigger one. Unknowing to them that little that you have given them is what is available at present. It's what's available at present. My dear viewers, we just have to be reasonable. We just have to be reasonable. Most especially when it comes to asking. Some of us don't know how to ask. And that is why we don't get help. Some of us don't know how to ask. That is why we don't get support. Some of us don't know how to ask. That is why nobody cares to assist. Nobody will assist you. Nobody will assist you because you have refused to ask properly. Jesus taught us how to ask. If you want to ask, first of all, know what you're asking for. Know what you're asking for. You understand now? Then, the next thing is, be clothed with humility. Be clothed with humility when asking. And when you ask, ask with humbleness. Ask with humbleness. Don't ask as if you are the owner. You are the owner of what you're asking for you to be able to get. For you to be able to get. If you don't ask,